Today we're looking at the fifth and final stage of the Metta Bhavana practice. And in this stage, we first of all bring everyone together that we've had in the practice so far and try and have metta for them. So ourselves, the good friend, the neutral person and the difficult person. And then based on that, we gradually expand outwards and think of more people and include more people in our meditation and in our awareness and loving kindness. So there's actually, two important aspects to this stage of the practice. And we're actually going to look at them over the next 2 days, the last 2 days of the urban retreat, because sometimes they can get a bit lost. And it's important, I think, to bring them out and really look at what's going on in this stage of the practice. So today we're just going to focus on the aspect of the practice, which is about bringing everyone together so far. Yeah. So what's that about? Why do we have an emphasis on that at this point in the Metta Bhavana? Yeah. So I think the reason for it is we're trying to bring everyone together so that we can have metta for them equally, so that we can try and hold them all in our awareness without preferences, without our likes and our dislikes getting in the way of our sense of metta and well-wishing for them. So different people are going to make us feel different things, but metta is universal. Metta is, in a way, unconditional. We're trying to have some sense of wishing people well, whatever kind of, however they make us feel. Even people who we find difficult, who make us feel uncomfortable, we're trying to have a sense of wanting them to be happy, to wish them well, as it were. So this bringing everyone together is a way of working with that, just noticing our preferences, our inclinations, and trying to kind of have an equal, even-handed attitude towards everyone. Yeah. So in other words, it's what you could call the Buddhist quality of equanimity. Yeah. And sometimes the word equanimity sounds a bit boring. It sounds a bit just kind of flat and bland, but it's not like that really. Equanimity is an emotional quality of freedom. It's being free to respond to people, anyone. Yeah, it's just being, it's free to respond to people appropriately. Yeah. So it's fine to have preferences. Of course we're going to have likes and dislikes. Of course we're going to get on with some people more easily and better than others. But we're trying not to get too fixed and rigid around our preferences, around our likes and dislikes, so that they don't rule us, so that we're not totally ruled by our feelings, yeah? So that we're able to respond to different people in different situations with kindness, with awareness, with metta. And we're not just moving away from certain people and moving towards certain people totally based on our feelings and preferences in that kind of way. So it's about really cultivating that ability to respond to different people and not be limited by our likes and dislikes in that kind of way. That's what we're trying to do in this particular phase of the practice. So I've got a few suggestions for how to go about that. Maybe the best one, the simplest one, is to just imagine everyone sat in a circle. So there's you, the good friend, the neutral person, and the difficult person. And yeah, you could just imagine you're there in a circle and you're trying to have this attitude of well-wishing and loving kindness towards all of you equally. Another way you might do it is just to think of each person and where they are right now. What are they doing right now? What's going through their mind right now? And just try to kind of connect with them as a human being and wish them well. And whatever you do, however you do this stage, just really trying to notice any inclination to think about one person and not think about another person. I'm really trying to even that out and consider everybody as equally as possible, as it were. Yeah. So you might still find some people easier than others, but your basic well-wishing and concern for them, you're trying to kind of even that out, as it were. Yeah. That's the gist of this aspect of the practice, of considering everyone in the practice so far. Yeah. So the lead meditation today, it will be the whole practice, but there'll be a particular focus on this aspect. And then tomorrow we'll be looking at the final aspect of the practice, which is just expanding out and including more and more people. And hopefully you can see why what we've done today is creating the conditions for that to happen. That equanimity, that kind of ability to respond freely, regardless of preference, is the kind of condition that's needed in order to be able to expand out and consider more and more people and expand our sphere of concern in that kind of way. So that's what we're going to look at tomorrow. In the meantime, there's the lead meditation, there's the final talk from Vasantra's series of talks, and also he'll be answering questions later on today, so do look out for that. And see you again tomorrow for the last day of our urban retreat.